Did you know your bank may be charging you as much as $4.50 every time you use an out-of-network ATM? Which means you're 100% guaranteed to lose money with each withdrawal. You'd have better luck with a slot machine. But with Westcom, you get access to 30,000 fee-free ATMs throughout North America. Westcom is member-owned, so you always come out a winner. Stop by one of our 22 area branches or check us out at westcom.org.
Blog Talk Radio.
Here we go.
Blast off.
This is True Capitalist Radio. True Capitalist Radio.
I am your host, the man they call Ghost.
The badass of business.
Give him capitalism or give him death.
That's it. Period.
Broadcasting from his Skylight Office Studios in beautiful downtown Austin, Texas.
You sound fruitier than a box of Fruit Loops, for Christ's sake.
And now, he'll take it from here. Your host, the prognosticator of prognosticators, the man they call...
Ghost.
That's right.
Woo! What's going on, folks? And thank you for tuning in with me to this random Sunday edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me to this random Sunday edition of the True Capitalist Radio show. And before we get into anything else, this is episode number 307 for all the folks that are keeping track, 307. And once again, folks, spread it around like wildfire because this is a special show, folks. I mean, if you were not following me on Twitter last evening at Politics Ghost, all one word, no underscores, Politics Ghost, well, you missed out on an evening of some adventure, of some fun, and some digital goddamn damage, baby. I'm telling you this right now. The capitalist army was not going to just stand by and watch Black Lives Matter sit back and just continuously wreak havoc on the country because of some fictitious, ridiculous, media-pumped ridiculousness, all right? I mean, I'm telling you this right now. Everyone is complicit, from the media to this Obama administration, George Soros. Everybody is complicit with rabble-rousing these groups of people, all right? And that's why we saw last night throughout the country all kinds of protests and rabble-rousing and violence. I mean, I've said it, and I will continue to say it. Black Lives Matter is a domestic terrorist organization, and I think that everybody needs to emphasize that in whatever medium you're communicating in. You need to tell everybody that you know that Black Lives Matter is a goddamn terrorist, domestic terrorist organization. Anyway, folks, I want to be completely honest with you. I've had a great time. If you were watching the Twitter timeline at Politics Ghost last night, you know as well as I, we were having a party last night, to say the least. Every Black Lives Matter folk was literally just bowing down to the capitalist army because, folks, first and foremost, once D-Ray got arrested, and look, I want to be completely honest with you, all right? I want to be completely honest with you. I can't confirm or deny if the capitalist army had anything to do with coordinating with the Baton Rouge police force in locating this individual. All I can say is I thought it was rather ridiculous that D-Ray decided to periscope his little protest in a, and let me tell you something, Louisiana is not a state that you want to be commiserating in if you're not a member of that state, if you're not a citizen of that state. All right, and obviously they didn't tell D-Ray that. And all you had to do, and telling you folks, all you had to do, once this idiot was on Periscope, call the Baton Rouge police and say, look, you've got the leader of this goddamn domestic terrorist organization there in your city marching right now, and he's broadcasting on the internets. And let me tell you something right now. I am glad he got arrested. And for you folks that are unaware, D-Ray is arrested. He was out there protesting and marching in Baton Rouge. And once again, folks, what was he doing there? He's a professional paid protester, all right? He is a professional paid rabble-rouser, all right? He is the supposed leader of the Black Lives Matter domestic terrorist organization, all right? And let me tell you, the capitalist army and everybody that was listening in or watching the timeline was giddy as hell. I mean, we were having a party. We were breaking out the popcorn, for Christ's sake. We were doing a little dance and making a little love and getting down tonight, watching D-Ray and the Black Lives Matter movement completely in shambles. And, folks, we continued that propaganda all through the morning up until this afternoon, folks. And let me tell you, I was completely unaware that D-Ray was actually a homosexual. All right? I'm serious. I had no idea. I mean, I basically just said that, you know, this man was, you know, a little fruity or whatever the case might be. I had no idea that D-Ray is an actual power bottom. And for you folks that are unaware with that, you know, you're on the internet. So go to the Urban Dictionary for that crap. He is a piggish power bottom fruit bowl that is leading a violent armed revolution. I mean, can you believe this crap? I mean, I'm telling you, everybody should plaster that at every so-called gangster wannabe Black Lives Matter terrorist social media site. You need to plaster the fact that Black Lives Matter is not a black organization. It is an LGBT movement, and I think that Black Lives Matter folk need to understand what's leading them around out here. And folks, when the Capitalist Army brought it to the attention of the mainstream Black Lives Matter movement that D-Ray likes to take it in the pooper, all right, all of a sudden the D-Ray, Free D-Ray, Black Lives Matter trend started to talk about, wait a minute, what? D-Ray's gay? Of course you didn't know. I mean, you didn't know? I mean, come on. You better ask somebody. Oh, my God. Anyway, folks, we had a great time last night. Once D-Ray got arrested, his right-hand dyke, or whatever she is, that fat meatball-looking broad, Nita, all right, she decided to go off on a Twitter tirade, for that matter. She went on a Twitter tirade, you know, calling out the cops, calling out all this garbage. And we just got so upset at her here at the Capitalist Army, we decided to go ahead and release her info, even though everybody thought we were bluffing. And, of course, we did that in the most careless and unsophisticated way possible so that we have no criminal intent in releasing the information of a public figure who, for a lack of a better term, is basically rabble-rousing the domestic terrorism that we're witnessing in America today. And I think it's within the public interest to know where this individual can be contacted so that just in case there's any recourse relating to the Black Lives Matter terrorism, folks can go and talk to somebody and ask him a few questions on why exactly were you rabble-rousing this nonsense? Why exactly are you promoting violence? Why exactly are you backing a domestic terrorist group? So on and so forth, folks. So I'm telling you right now, that's why Black Lives Matter doesn't want to have nothing to do with the Capitalist Army. Do you understand that, boy? All right, Black Lives Matter doesn't want nothing to do with the Capitalist Army. I'm telling you, if you don't believe me, go tweet at D-Ray. Go tweet at Nita, all right? Tweet at these so-called Black Lives Matter leaders and tell them you're a part of the Capitalist Army. They'll ignore you faster than you can even imagine. As a matter of fact, I heard from many of the Capitalist Army folk that they're already pre-banned. They're already pre-blocked as if they're D-Ray and Nita are going through my goddamn Twitter followers and just ignoring everybody who follows me, for Christ's sake. Why are you scared, boy? Why are you scared? I mean, you're out here trying to lead a domestic terrorist organization in Black Lives Matter in an attempt to rise up violence against the American public. You're trying to cause civil unrest. folks, before I get into any more of this, I definitely want Black Lives Matter folk to be listening into this. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go ahead and turn this part of the show over into some early, very early Twitter shout-outs. And for you folks that are unaware on how to get a Twitter shout-out here live on the broadcast, all you have to do is retweet the first tweet on my Twitter account, and the Twitter account is PoliticsGhost, all one word, no underscores, PoliticsGhost is the name, and retweet the tweet that says, True Capitalist Radio, now live. You retweet that tweet right now, I will give you a Twitter shout-out live right here on the broadcast. And the reason we want as many retweets as possible, because we want everybody in each and every one of these trends to, you know, grab along, listen to the show. I want to hear from Black Lives Matter. All right? I want them to call in, for Christ's sake, all right? I'm serious. I'm not kidding around. I want them to defend the domestic terrorism that the Black Lives Matter movement is causing across America. I want them to justify it. I'm serious. So, by God, right now, if you want a Twitter shout-out, retweet the first tweet on the Twitter account. All right, boy? All right. Hey, engineer, do we have any Twitter shout-outs to be had out here? All right. Well, we got a few Twitter shout-outs, and let's start them right now. Woo! Anyway, who we got here? We got Sergeant Yoda in the house. We've got the Prophet. What's going on? We've got Alu Akbar. Oh, give me a break with that name. We've got Cody from Unknown in the place. We've got Welfare Refugee. Oh, yeah, real funny ass crack, all right? As a matter of fact, I think that's what Black Lives Matter should be focusing more on, that refugees and illegal immigrants are being treated better than they are by the black president-led government. How you like that there, Black Lives Matter, boy? Woo! Anyway, we've got, what's going on, dude, with the engineer for VP? What the hell does that mean? Anyway, we got the trans ghost. Shove it up your ass with that crap. What's going on to J-Rob in the house? Capitalist UK in the house. Havel the Rock. We've got, I'm not going to say that disgusting name. Buttered Up Artery, asshole. Buttered Up Artery. I'm telling you, it's not the butter, so shut up. And look, I'm not even going to talk about that right now. Do you understand that? We're having a celebration of D-Ray being arrested. Unfortunately, I just read the reports that he was just bonded out. I wouldn't be surprised if representatives of the Obama administration or the Justice Department or Hillary Clinton paid the bill on that one, in my personal opinion, for this unemployed professional protester. What a piece of trash. Anyway, we got no gifts for ghosts. Yeah, you know what? Screw you, asshole, all right? Anyway, we got TCR Terror Organization. Oh, no, don't you even go there, asshole. Don't you even go there. TCR Terrorist Organization. I got your terrorist organization right here. Right here, boy. Stupid son of a bitch. Don't even go there, boy. All right, don't even go there. All right, we are patriots. All right, we are capitalists. All right, what we are trying to do is we are trying to stop the communist takeover of our country. We are trying to stop this domestic terrorist organization that is Black Lives Matter, that is being backed up by this liberal Democrat government, that is being funded by the Prince of Freaking Darkness, George Soros. That's what we're trying to stop. That's what we're trying to put a point of emphasis on, put a spotlight on, for Christ's sake. That's what we're doing. What are you doing besides sitting there playing pocket pool looking at cartoons, you stupid fruity-ass bastard? Anyway, we got Squid Girl for Ghost, Dr. Franken Ghost. Jesus Christ. We got Ryan Richards in the house. Who the hell else do we got going on? Once again, if you want a Twitter shout-out live right here on the broadcast, retweet the first tweet on my Twitter account. It's that goddamn simple, boy. Anyway, we got the Brony Network in the house. Who the hell else do we got? We got Speed Drinking. What's going on? TCR Ball Pit. What the hell does that mean? What the hell does that mean? Anyway, we got Carolina Ghost in here. We got Hans Guvensmith. We got John S.K. in the place. The Trans Ghostler. Hey, assholes, don't call me Ghostler, assholes. That's not even funny. We got Don't Pick Up D-Ray. Blood Chuckle. Oh, Jesus Christ. We got Popeye in the house. We've got the molested trans blood. What the hell is that? You put a pair of balls on a drop of blood, for Christ's sake? I mean, good God! We got Vetiforum Wars in the house, Exara Hawks, Choco Latte, Transonic Plague, asshole, Transonic Plague. Oh my God, what a bunch of garbage. And what a Kennedy Space Center, oh, give me a break. That, you know what, if you're with NASA, get out. Get the hell out, NASA, you bunch of fraudulent pieces of nerd herd crap. Sick of NASA, I'm sick of them. Biggest waste of money in world history, as far as I'm concerned. Jesus Christ. Who the hell else do we got? We got Z Frostwire in the house. What's going on to Z Frostwire? We got Cookie in the house. We got Aborted D-Ray. We got Charles Ghostman. No, let's not even go there, asshole. It's not even funny. That's not even funny. We got Jerry G in the house. Top Badge in the place. Auto Fellatio God, whatever the hell that's supposed to mean, Jesus Christ. We've got Ghost Ray, oh, here we go. No, don't even go there. Don't compare me to that piggish power bottom fruit bowl who's leading a domestic Black Lives Matter terrorist organization in freaking D-Ray. All right, and the reason I'm asking everybody to please retweet the broadcast and to please retweet the first tweet on the Twitter account is so that we can get as many Black Lives Matter supporters listening in, and if they get a little upset, if they get a little angry, well, by God, they can give me a call right now. We can have a little bit of a talk about it. Anyway, let's continue going, shall we? We got free D-Ray now. Oh, that's great. That's great. We got Radiant Snake in the house. We got Gigapower, Ghost Walks on the Moon. Look, don't make any more NASA references, ass crack. I'm serious, all right? I'm not joking. They replaced Ghost. What the hell is that supposed to mean? What the hell is that supposed to mean? They replaced Ghost. Shove it up your ass. I'm right here, boy. Do you understand that? I've been going on since 2008 on this broadcast, and don't you ever forget about it, you milky liquor. Anyway, we've got Oops Poops, whatever the hell that's supposed to mean. First Love for Ghosts, what the hell does that mean? D-Ray the Panda, oh, Jesus Christ, man. Enough! We've got D-Ray Detainted. We've got the Trans President. We've got Godzilla Still Sucks. Come on, man, come on! Jesus Christ. Ghost bullies the engineer. Let me tell you something, you asshole. The engineer is my employee, all right? He's getting time and a half, for Christ's sake. He's working overtime. He's actually probably going to go, what, you going to do something after this, engineer? Mm-hmm. Well, he's going to go and do something. He's going to spend his money, whatever he does, all right?
The deals are getting hotter during the Deer Days of Summer. Get 0% financing for 60 months on all John Deere compact tractors. Plus, get a best-in-class 6-year powertrain warranty at no additional cost. Hurry in today for the hot deals of summer. Offer ends August 2nd, 2016, subject to approved installment credit with John Deere Financial. Terms, conditions, exclusions, and warranty limitations apply. See dealer for details.
Visit your local John Deere dealer today to take advantage of special savings going on now. Find out more at myjohndeeredealer.com.
Christ. Ghost Power Top D-Ray? You son of a... God damn it! You sick, twisted prick! Damn it! God damn it! All right, that's enough of the goddamn Twitter shout-outs if that's what you're going to be doing, boy. If you're going to be making trolls with me and that piggish power bottom fruit bowl D-Ray... Well, then that's it. I'm not going to do any more Twitter shout-outs. I am not going to be besmirched. This is a time to celebrate that we have put a point of emphasis on D-Ray by him getting arrested in goddamn Baton Rouge, for Christ's sake. And let me tell you something. Give me the mic. Give me the mic. Give me the goddamn mic. Let me tell you something else, folks. All right, the Black Lives Matter folks, throughout the morning, ever since yours truly was out here posting those tweets, emphasizing that D-Ray is a broke-back brother, all right? I'm serious. I mean, it's not a joke. I mean, the man is a power bottom, all right? I mean, I even tweeted a speech of his that he gave to, you know, the gay organization out of San Francisco, in which he talks about how he called his dad about relationship advice with his first boyfriend. Oh, isn't that great? That sounds so revolutionary, doesn't it? That sounds so like violent revolutionary. He called his dad about relationship advice about his boyfriend. I mean, get the hell out of here, for Christ's sake, man. Good God. And one more thing. For you Black Lives Matter people that are following this, that are getting rabble-roused by this, that believe that you're, you know, some kind of resurrection of Tupac's thug life or whatever you people are thinking this Black Lives Matter movement is, how does it feel to know that you're being led around by a bottom bitch? I mean, seriously. I'm not joking. I mean, look. It was Plato who said that man has two paths to life, and they cannot intertwine those paths. The path to recognition, because Plato believed that the basis of man's motivation is recognition, to be recognized as being a good artist, recognized as being a good inventor, recognized as being a good teacher, being a good builder, you know, being a good whatever. All right? I mean, that's all there is to it. So, what's the other path? The other path is when man submits to their desires. They basically bypass the avenue of recognition, and they submit to their desires. Now, you cannot demand recognition and submit to your desires at the same time. And case in point, D-Ray is exactly what I'm talking about. You cannot be the leader of some supposed revolutionary, violent, armed group that's trying to take over America and at the same time being a bottom boy and servicing glory holes and probably has a goddamn account on Grindr. I mean, that doesn't work, man. All right? I'm serious. That does not work anymore. All right? It's never worked. Not anymore. It's never worked. And look, I'm not trying to say if you happen to be somebody who likes to take in the pooper and you're a bottom and you're homosexual, I'm not trying to say that homosexuals can't do things, all right? I mean, they could be smart folks. They can do jobs. I'm not trying to say anything. But this man, D-Ray, is attempting to try to rise up a violent revolution based upon black racism. And this man is taking it in the pooper, all right? I want to know, give me a call right now if you happen to be a Black Lives Matter supporter. 516-453-9903 is the number to call. If you happen to be a Black Lives Matter supporter, please, I'd like for you to explain to me, how does it make you feel that Black Lives Matter is not an organization based upon the progress or whatever it's about as it relates to black people. But I am here to assure you that Black Lives Matter is an LGBT movement. It is a homosexual movement. I mean, folks, why do you think a picture of Obama came out today of him wearing pink headphones in power bottom solidarity with D-Ray, who was jailed in Baton Rouge? I mean, I'm serious. You brothers need to realize that Black Lives Matter is a homosexual LGBT project, all right? I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if Nita isn't doing a little bit of muff diving, but unfortunately she shitted out a couple of kids who, I wonder who's taking care of those children, you know what I mean? I'm serious. I mean, I'm sick. I am so sick of the idea that these black thugs that are out here committing all this violence, they don't realize they're being led around by LGBT leaders. I mean, how does that make you feel? I mean, let's just say it. All right, brothers, I want to know, if you're listening to me, Black Lives Matter brothers, I want to know, who is gay for D-Ray? Huh? Oh, I'm asking you, Black Lives Matter brothers. Who is gay for D-Ray? Who's gay for D-Ray? I'm just asking a question. I mean, you guys in Black Lives Matter are throwing your lives on the line. You're committing all kinds of acts of terrorism, domestic terrorism. You're rabble-rousing. You're breaking your own communities. You're tearing your own communities apart. And who is leading you, for Christ's sake? A power bottom who probably services glory holes, who probably has an account on Grindr, who's taking it up the pooper. I mean, seriously, is that what you want, Black Lives Matter? I mean, do you want to be an LGBT organization? Because that's what it is. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, but you need to understand what is truly rabble-rousing you into this type of violent hysteria. All right? I'm serious. I'm not kidding around. So, once again, I strongly advise each and every one of you Black Lives Matter supporters to reevaluate who exactly is leading you down this path to hell. Because let me tell you what this is doing. All this that's transpiring cannot end well, especially for you folks. All right? I mean, look, I am not trying to say anything as it relates to, nor am I trying to advocate any kind of racial tension, any kind of violence. But if the Black Lives Matter domestic terrorist organization continues with its violent acts, I mean, they are putting themselves in a predicament in which people of America are finally going to get fed up. And you see, this is exactly what the government wants to happen. That's the unfortunate part about it. I mean, that's what George Soros is funding. That's why Obama is bringing in all these folks. That's why he's rabble-rousing them in his speeches. Same with Loretta Lynch. Same with goddamn Hillary Rotten Clinton. Same with Facebook. Same with Google. I mean, all these people, MTV, they're all colluding to rabble-rouse these folks. And you see, when you advertise that, oh, you're being oppressed, so you should go out and kill cops, they're going to go do it. And that's what they're doing right now. That is what they are doing right now. So anyway, folks, all I'm saying is that we as Americans need to recognize what's going on here, recognize who are the actors involved, who's rabble-rousing who, who's funding who, and who's backing who. All right? We've got D-Ray, Nita, and a couple of other people that are organizing these Black Lives Matter rabble-rousing episodes throughout the country. They've already discussed it in the hacked private messages out of D-Ray's Twitter that they are in communication with the Department of Justice so that D-Ray and his organization can rabble-rouse and cause violence at both Democratic and the Republican conventions so that this administration can administer martial law. And I'm telling you this right now. I don't know where you Black Lives Matter supporters think this is all going to end up, but it ain't going to end up very good, especially for you folks. All right? You're just twisting whatever hatred that you believe that this country is giving you, which, come on, folks. I mean, hatred. I mean, there's only 258 black folks killed at the gun of a police officer last year. And let's just say all of them were unjustified and they were bad and so on and so forth. That's 258 people. There were 500 people killed in Chicago. 500 black people killed in Chicago last year by other black people. Where are the rallies over there to stop the violence? Where are the rallies to tell the black folks that are in Chicago to put their guns down? Where are all those causes at? Oh, well, no, it's not going to put a camera in my face, and the mainstream media isn't going to cover that. I mean, I'm telling you this right now. This is what this is all about. So once again, folks, I am putting it towards Black Lives Matter. I'm calling you all out, all right? Each and every one of you Black Lives Matter supporters, which one of you is gay for D-Ray? As a matter of fact, since we are now recognizing that Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, whether you want to believe it or not, folks, it's being led by a freaking piggish power bottom fruit bowl, And not that there's anything wrong with that, but I personally believe that there's something wrong with a power bottom bitch boy leading a violent revolution in America. It doesn't even sound right. You know what I mean? It doesn't even sound applicable. I'm not joking. Oh, my God. Anyway, folks, let's continue going here because, I mean, look, D-Ray got arrested. He just got bailed out. I'm sure the State Department or the DOJ or somebody bailed his ass out. I'm sure it came out of the taxpayer's dime or George Soros or somebody because this son of a bitch ain't employed. Now he is. Excuse me. He just got a job with Baltimore City Schools. My apologies. All right? Anyway, folks, let me continue going because it is time to let Black Lives Matter know that Black Lives Matter is an LGBT movement. I mean, spread that around the internet and throughout the world. Let everybody know that Black Lives Matter is an LGBT movement. I guarantee you the brothers ain't going to like that. I guarantee you the brothers ain't going to like that because the brothers are down low brothers, a lot of them. And they don't want to be out in the open. They want to keep that on the down low, baby. You understand like that? I'm not joking. I mean, folks, if you did not read the trends on Twitter, the Twitter trends, D-Ray, Black Lives Matter, Free D-Ray, once they caught wind that D-Ray was a power bottom, there was humongous debates throughout the trends on, wait a minute, D-Ray's gay? I mean, they can't believe it. The brothers, they can't believe that they have been led by a bottom homosexual. I mean, it's not even the fact that, I don't want to go there, but let me tell you what we're going to do right now, all right? I tell you what we're going to do right now. In the spirit of Obama, who wore his pink headphones while working out in Poland when he was out there talking to NATO and figuring out how they're going to confront Russia with a nuclear confrontation, he was wearing pink headphones in power bottom solidarity with D-Ray, and I'm asking you Black Lives Matter brothers one more again. I'm asking you Black Lives Matter brothers one more again. Who is gay for D-Ray? Now, since D-Ray, you know, he's obviously a piggish power bottom, we're going to go ahead and celebrate the fact that Black Lives Matter has came out of the closet. It is a gay movement. It is a homosexual movement, LGBT movement. And I hope that all the Black Lives Matter realize this. I mean, hey, look, your boy D-Ray, he was speaking in front of GLAAD. I tweeted that goddamn video. He was speaking in front of GLAAD talking about how, I remember calling my dad for relationship advice, and I wasn't in the closet per se, but I was in the dark as it related to me taking in the pooper. But I'm D-Ray. I'm serious. I mean, how does that Black Lives Matter, brothers? How does that make you feel? That you're being led around the nose, and what you're truly representing is an LGBT movement. It has nothing to do with black strife. It has nothing to do with rebuilding black communities. It has nothing to do with re-educating black people. It has nothing to do with bringing economy to black communities. It has nothing to do with keeping black families together. It has everything to do with destroying you people. I mean, that's what Black Lives Matter is doing. It is destroying your communities, whatever community you have left. I mean, take a look at what happened to Ferguson. Ferguson, they rioted, and where did they riot? They rioted their own minority businesses. I mean, what sense does this make? Seriously, what sense does this make? It doesn't make any sense. And that's why I'm telling each and every one of the Black Lives Matter supporters, you are being led around by the nose by an LGBT organization that is masking itself behind an idea that is racially based. And the proof is in the pudding. I mean, do you remember at least Martin Luther King, he would try to march and try to put some positive nonviolent connotation as it relates to the strife of black folk? I mean, this man was trying to encourage two-parent black families. He was trying to encourage the content of one's character to be judged, not the color of their skin. You understand? So all I'm saying is, folks, what is happening here in the Black Lives Matter movement is nothing to do with bringing up the black race, helping the black race, facilitating the black race to a better reality, a better community, a better relations with other races. Nothing. It has everything to do with destroying black America. And if you don't believe me, just take a look at what Black Lives Matter is doing. Take a look who's funding these people. George Soros, the prince of freaking darkness, man. George Soros is the same man who, as a teenager, became a Nazi sympathizer, and he was Jewish. He was Jewish. He became a Nazi sympathizer and sold out his own people and put them in the gas chambers and helped the Nazis, you know, put them in the gas chambers, took other people's property, the whole nine yards, and calls it the greatest time in his life. That's what he calls it. I'm not joking. This is the kind of sick Prince of Darkness psychopath that we're dealing with in George Soros. This man called him being a Nazi collaborator as a teenager, sending his own Jewish people into the ovens, the greatest time of his life. And this is who's funding Black Lives Matter. Do you get it now, black folk? Do you get it, for Christ's sake? This has nothing to do with race relations. This has nothing to do with bringing up black people. It has nothing to do with anything other than utilizing black strife as a tool for violence to justify the totalitarianism that this government wants to inflict upon the entire American populace. And the sooner that you Black Lives Matter folks start realizing that, the better your race will be. You know, y'all talk a lot about Malcolm X, and I guarantee you not one of you sorry sacks of crap that claim to be Black Lives Matter have even read the damn autobiography of Malcolm X as told to by Alex Haley. Because if you did, you wouldn't be out here doing the kind of ridiculousness that you're conducting yourself in today. All right? I mean, Malcolm X advocated an independent black community. Malcolm X advocated that the black people should own their own businesses, own their own homes, own their own schools, teach their own children, have their own communities, have their own money. But instead, look at what you Black Lives Matter folks are doing today. You are submitting to the state, and you believe that the state is going to somehow give you social justice, when all the state is doing to you folks is utilizing you folks as a mechanism of terror, a mechanism of destruction, so that they, the bureaucrats that are in power today, I'm talking about Obama, I'm talking about the people that are in charge in Washington today, they can implement totalitarianism on us all. They can implement totalitarianism on us all.
You give to all kinds of stuff, from your buddy Jim, who's helping a cause that sounds good, to your cousin's random crowdfunding project. And now you can give to another cause. You. Because one in three of us isn't saving enough for retirement, Prudential is hosting the 4.01k Race for Retirement on September 17th. It's a fun run that helps you save more for you. Join us on September 17th at the Rose Bowl. Register for free at run401k.com. Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey.
So anyway, without any further ado, folks, I want to celebrate the coming out party of Black Lives Matter. They are an LGBT organization. They are an LGBT movement. I mean, I don't know how much more evidence that you Black Lives Matter folks need to understand. You got D-Ray over here, who is a piggish, power-bottom, fruity ass, who I would not doubt if you happen to be in a shit stall next to D-Ray, if you happen to be accidentally tapping your toes because you're, you know, trying to move around your sphincter so that you can, you know, pinch a loaf, this idiot will come out and get down on all fours from the other shit stall. I wouldn't be surprised if he had the grinder app. I mean, this is the kind of things that you need to start whirling around in your head there, Black Lives Matter. This is what you're being led around about. I mean, Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization. And, you know, to celebrate that, folks, I got, hey, engineer, do you got some music for this? Well, I got some, you know, let me think about it here. We're going to put on some LGBT-like music, and we are going to celebrate the coming out party of Black Lives Matter being an LGBT organization. Now, when I'm trying to think of a gay song here you know, that signifies the essence of the power bottom, so that we can, you know, celebrate the coming out party of Black Lives Matter. So let me think here. Hey, engineer, how about the old school Calvin Harris when he was taken in the pooper? You know, before Taylor Swift put some money into him and made him up, forced him to go to a trainer and, you know, gave him facelifts and all that. Remember, he was fruiting up, remember? You do remember that, right, engineer? Well, listen, I believe the song by Calvin Harris, and I'm talking old school Fruit Bowl Calvin Harris, is called Disco Heat. It's a power bottom song. Do you got that back there, engineer? Well, go ahead and get that queued up, folks, and I'd like for everybody right now to contact any Black Lives Matter supporter that you know. Send them the link to this show. We are celebrating Black Lives Matter coming out of the closet, baby, and we're going to do so by playing a song so that we can celebrate the fact that Black Lives Matter is finally coming out of the closet. There's no more Down Low Brother stuff. Woo! Hey, engineer, how about a little bit of Calvin Harris Disco Heat? That's a little Fruit Bowl song. He talks about taking in the pooper in that song. You got that queued up there, boy? Well, hurry it up, for Christ's sake. We're celebrating Black Lives Matter coming out of the closet. Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, and I think that every Black Lives Matter supporter needs to understand that. So without any further ado, you got that queued up, engineer? All right, without any further ado, let's go ahead and put on some Calvin Harris Disco Heat, in which he talks about being a power bottom and taking it bareback. I swear to God, that's what the song is about. So let's go ahead and let's play this. This is for Black Lives Matter coming out of the closet, baby. Coming out of the LGBT closet. Go ahead and put it on, engineer.
Inside me is a flame. The burn brighter anytime you take me. Gets me right.
Oh, my God. Couldn't do any more fruitier than this, baby.
It learned how to fit into my form.
Ray! Oh! Oh, yeah, did you see that Fruit Bowl? Ah! Did you hear that? That's a Fruit Bowl power bottom crap! This is Black Lives Matter right here, an LGBT organization! This is for you, Black Lives Matter! This is for you! Ah! Uh-oh! Black Lives Matter, LGBT, LGBT, Black Lives Matter, LGBT, Black Lives Matter, LGBT, Black Lives Matter, LGBT. They've come out of the closet, baby, they came out of the closet. This is for you, D-Ray, you Black Lives Matter, you're coming out of the closet, baby. Your power bottoms. Power bottoms, baby. You're coming out of the closet, Black Lives Matter. You're coming out of the closet. How does it feel? How does it feel? Woo! Oh, man. Black Lives Matter is taking in the pooper. They're taking in the pooper. How does it feel, Black Lives Matter, to come out of the closet, baby? How does it feel? How does it feel to come out of the closet? Oh, my.
Inside me is a flame. The burn brighter anytime you take me. Gets in the way when I'm alone with you. But disappears if I'm with someone new.
Yeah, this is D-Ray jam here. I bet you that's how D-Ray sounds in the Baton Rouge jail, baby. Hey, Black Lives Matter is coming out of the closet, baby. It's LGBT movement.
That's what it is, baby. Woo! Woo! Shantae! Black Lives Matter. It's an LGBT thing, baby. It's an LGBT thing, that Black Lives Matter thing.
Oh, my God.
How does it feel, Black Lives Matter, fruit bowls? You're taking in the pooper, aren't you? I know it. Woo, it's a coming out party for Black Lives Matter, baby. They're being yanked out of the closet thanks to D-Ray. Hey, Black Lives Matter, who's gay for D-Ray? Who's gay for D-Ray? Who's gay for D-Ray? Who's gay for D-Ray? Wah, 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 wah. Taking a pooper. D-Ray takes in the pooper. Woo! 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 How does it feel, Black Lives Matter? How does it feel, boy?
Oh, man. That was fun. I'll tell you that right now. That, my friends, was Calvin Harris back in the day when he took it up the pooper before the whole Taylor Swift makeover thing. With his song Disco Heat, where he talks about
inside me was a flame that burned inside me every time you came.
I mean, you couldn't get any more fruit bowl than that crap. And not to mention, what does that say about Taylor Swift on a sidebar? I mean, what's up with Taylor Swift? She must be more of a freak show in the sack than, everybody kind of anticipates. I mean, she's getting with some fool that wrote this song back in the day. He's taken a couple of meat in the can, to say the least. That's all I'm going to say. I mean, give me a break. But anyway, back to the point here, folks. Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, and I want to hear from you. I want to hear from Black Lives Matter, folks. I want to hear what you have to say, all right? That's what I want to hear. I want to hear what you have to say, baby. So let's go ahead and get to some calls here, folks. We're opening up the phone lines. It is an free format random Sunday edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And I want to hear from you. What are your thoughts about everything that has transpired throughout the week? And once again, I want to say how convenient all this happened right after the James Comey testimony, right after the legitimate, crooked, corrupt, disgusting bureaucratic system slapping America in the face with this ridiculous nonsense. That, yeah, Hillary Clinton, she did it, but she didn't mean to do it. She didn't have any criminal intent to do it. And she was just basically careless and unsophisticated in her attempts. I mean, give me a break! I mean, that's what Black Lives Matter should be more pissed at, you stupid idiots, at the fact that we have a two-tier system in which the bureaucrats, anyone who's in Washington, is above the law as it relates to any of the laws that they passed on us. It is utterly disgusting, and it makes me sick. It makes me sick. Anyway, we're taking calls here, all right? 516-453-9903. It's the coming out party of Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization. And we all know it because of the leader, D-Ray, a power bottom, leading Black Lives Matter into this ridiculous, violent revolution against America. But by God, they're being led around by LGBT. How does it feel? How does it feel, Black Lives Matter? How does it feel to be led around by a power bottom who takes it in the pooper? I mean, I'm sure some of these brothers are probably like, man, I can't believe motherfucking D-Ray, that motherfucker out there, he's taking in the ass, man. Come on, man. I'm sure. I mean, I saw it all over Twitter. They're having debates. They're having debates about it. That they couldn't believe that D-Ray was taking in the pooper. And then folks that were defending D-Ray were like, man, what does D-Ray being gay have to do with the movement, baby? What does that have to do with the movement? It has everything to do with the movement. Because remember, folks, gay people think that they supersede black folk in the chain of strife. Remember that. I'm not kidding around. All right? I mean, they actually believe that your strife, I'm talking the black people's strife, is the same as their strife, if not worse. They think that their strife is a lot worse than yours. So, you know, try to chew on that for a little bit, for Christ's sake. Anyway, let's take some calls here. How about the area code 619? You're on the horn. What's going on? Hey, 619, you there? Hey, are you there?
Hey, it's my, it's Asho.
Hey, what's going on, Asho? How you doing, man?
Sorry, it's because my brother called. And, wait, I didn't even call you, it was my brother, to be honest. Just talk to him. Hey.
I'm going to promote my brother's drone videos. If you haven't checked them out, go check them out at his Twitter. My brother does drone videos, and I don't know why, but he hasn't promoted his videos. So help him capitalize on that. Thank you. Goodbye.
All right. Well, hey, thank you. Hey, Asho.
Hey, what's up? Sorry, I didn't even know I was on the line.
It's okay. Hey, what do you think about what's going on with all this Black Lives Matter and all the rabble-rousing and violence happening all over the country?
To be honest, I think it's the same thing as the KKK, that Black Lives Matter. I've always thought it was the same thing as the KKK for black people because they're pretty much separating themselves as a whole. You know what I mean?
Well, no, they're not even doing it appropriately. That's why I even alluded to the fact that when Malcolm X talked about the separation of the black race from the white race, he talked about it from a complete separation in which they are not even dependent on the government. I mean, Malcolm X was completely against entitlements, completely against welfare, completely against any kind of government program system. I mean, he said it in his autobiography that once the government came into his personal home as a child, that was the destruction of his family. So, but you see, these Black Lives Matter folks, they're real quick to, you know, talk about Malcolm X, and they're real quick to talk about all these characters that they think they know about when they don't know jack crap. So you're absolutely
yeah.
right. I think that they're racist, and, you know, they're obviously pent up. They've been rabble-roused through media, our government, been funded by George Soros. But what's unfortunate about them is that they are very uneducated on why they're putting their lives on the line, on why exactly they're going out and marching and causing ruckuses and destroying their own communities. I mean, this is what I'm saying. I agree with you that they are a racist organization, but at least the Ku Klux Klan, as stupid and as ignorant, as ridiculous and as pathetic as they are, the true Klan actually had a basis for whatever in the hell was in their stupid cockamamie minds. They actually could discuss this and try to explain to you why exactly they believe this ridiculous racist nonsense. You see, Black Lives Matter can't do that. Every time I've heard a Black Lives Matter supporter on TV, all I've heard is, man, they're killing us, baby. That ain't cool, baby. We got to kill Whitey, baby. I mean, you know, there is no articulation. It doesn't even have to be articulate. I mean, just convey what it is that is upsetting you. Convey what it is that's making you racist. Convey what it is that's making you act this way, and they can't do it. So, this is the difference, in my opinion, from the KKK to Black Lives Matter. And not only that, we don't see the Ku Klux Klan out here committing mass atrocities, killing police. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to say they've never killed anybody. I'm not trying to say they've never committed acts of violence. But for the most part, I mean, we have not seen anything here within the past 10 to 15 years that would justify this type of violence being implemented by the black community. Or I shouldn't say the black community, but Black Lives Matter. So
yeah.
any last words there, Asho?
No, but like I haven't really been following like this whole Black Lives Matter, like the whole thing going on with the shooting or how that cop shot the black guy. I haven't really been following haven't even been listening to the show as much because I've been busy. Sorry, Ghost. And but like I said, to be honest, the whole Black Lives Matter just proves the point, because why, like, I'm Mexican. I've never been stopped in my life. I've never been, you know, like, every time I see one of these Black Lives Matter videos, they're always against the cop. They always have some sort of attitude towards a cop, and that makes the cop, you know, use some brute force.
Happy Christmas, Ghost.
Shut up.
Yeah, no, I completely agree with you, Asho. I mean, I have seen, as a matter of fact, if you go to these Vine clips and these World Star Hip Hop clips, I mean, a lot of these, many of these folks in the black community, especially the youth, they like to antagonize cops and put it on video. I mean, I've seen it firsthand. And you see, don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to say that cops aren't bad. I mean, I know there's bad cops. I mean, believe me, I've been a vocal against the abuse of a cop and how cops basically just, abuse their power a lot of the times. But what people need to understand is that if you knew the law and if you articulated the law and communicated the law with the officer and the officer continues to infringe upon your person, well, then that officer could legitimately, if not be fired, you could throw a civil suit on him individually because he didn't follow the color of law. But you see, do you hear D-Ray discussing this with Black Lives Matter that, hey, look, maybe if a cop is going to approach you in a certain capacity, maybe you shouldn't be there and trying to antagonize him with curse words and, antagonize him with any kind of potential pent-up anger or anything of that nature. Even if the cop is coming at you in an angry capacity, all you have to do is say, sir, I'm not being upset. I know for a fact that you're here to serve and protect, and you're I'm a taxpayer. I mean, you know, these are the kinds of things that you need to say, even if they are being intimidating. And if they are, just say, look, I want to speak to your supervisor, and the supervisor has to be called out, you know, even if you have to comply. I'm not trying to say that you can't get out of your car, that you shouldn't, like these ACLU promoted ideas, that you shouldn't get out of your car, that, you know, you shouldn't obey the police, that you shouldn't give your license. I mean, you're just giving a cop probable cause, to basically act in a physical capacity so that they can identify who you are, especially if you're in a motor vehicle. Now, if you're on the street, and it depends on the circumstances, and a cop comes up to you, you don't necessarily have to talk to the cop unless you're a part of an investigation. Unless you are being thought that you're going to commit a crime or about to commit a crime, you don't have to talk to the police. But do you hear D-Ray telling these Black Lives Matter folk that? No. You're seeing him rabble-rouse these people so that they can basically act like sacrificial lambs so that they can make him more of a star, of some sort of a revolutionary, so on and so forth, man. So I completely agree with you, Asho. You want to give me a Twitter handle, man?
I forgot my Twitter name. Oh, it's like 2-3 A's, 4 S's, and 4 H's, something like that. I don't even go on it that much.
What's going on, man? You're doing a lot of things in real life, or what's going on?
Well, it's just I can't keep up. Like I can't keep up with everything, you know. Like it's too. I haven't been able to keep up with yesterday's show because I was out in Mexicali. I don't know if you know where Mexicali is. And I've been working a lot, so.
Take out his drone video.
Shut up! Oh my god.
Oh yeah. Man, well, hey, just keep on capitalizing, Asho. I mean, hey, whenever you can come by, whenever you can call in, we appreciate you calling in. But keep capitalizing and. Moreover, I hope you're scoring pretty good with the ladies. I know you've been talking about that. How's the lady department?
I don't know. It's looking pretty excellent. And by the way, my brother brought up the drone thing. I'll probably be making like a YouTube channel on drones because I film drone videos right now, and I think they're pretty good. And I'll be making a YouTube channel soon on that to see where that gets me, if it gets me
all
anywhere.
All right, man. Well, that's good, Asho, man. I'm really glad. Thank you for calling. I'm glad that you came from an 8-year-old Justin Bieber Mexican kid when you were trolling this show back in 2011 to now an upstanding member of America, going to college, thinking in entrepreneurial style. I'm really happy for old Asho here, man. I'm serious. I'm really happy. Anyway, folks, what we are doing here today is we're opening up the phone lines. This is a celebration of Black Lives Matter coming out of the closet. It is an LGBT organization. It is being ran by a piggish power bottom in D-Ray who spoke at GLAAD in San Francisco, who is, I mean, I just can't believe this. I can't believe that Black Lives Matter and the kind of violence that they're conducting, and as machismo and as badass and as thug life and as thuggery as they think they are being led around by a man who gets down on all fours and will take on all comers, literally and figuratively, all right?
Let's play a game. I'll tell you three things about retirement, and you spot the lie. One, 1 in 3 Americans isn't saving enough. 2, retirement could last 30 years or more. 3, half of people under 30 aren't saving at all. We lied. They're all true. That's why we're inviting you to the 4.01k Race for Retirement by Prudential on September 17th, a fun run that helps you save more for the future. So join us on September 17th at the Rose Bowl. Register for free at run401k.com. Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey.
Anyway, folks, I want to hear from you, all right? 516-453-9903 is the number to call. How about area code 321? You're on the horn.
Hey, Ghost. I was wondering what you think about Donald Trump picking a general as a vice presidential candidate in case the left kind of tries to take him out and, you know, pull some kind of trickery.
Well, you know, I actually think it's a very good idea. As a matter of fact, the general in question, I've been a very big fan of. I was talking about how this general, when I came back very seldomly back in November when I put out that YouTube video, I was basically utilizing my YouTube account to try to comment and try to get people to look at certain videos. And one of the videos I emphasized was Michael T. Flynn, General Michael T. Flynn, which is now being vetted as a potential vice presidential candidate for Donald Trump. This man was out vocalizing once he was pushed out of the DIA, because he was the head of the DIA, the Defense Intelligence Agency, which is nothing more than the CIA for the Pentagon. He was pushed out because he disagreed with the policies of one Barack Obama. And he even was sat down and interviewed and discussed this in great detail, in which he discussed and said, and I quote, that it was a voluntarily decision for Barack Obama to arm, train, and fund ISIS. I mean, this man came out and vocalized that this administration is arming, funding, and aiding ISIS. So I think it's a great deal that Donald Trump is vetting Michael T. Flynn especially for this vice presidential position. Because, like you said, the caller here, if one of these freak showish leftists decide to take a pop shot at Trump, they're going to have a military man as the president, and I think that's the last thing that you want, for Christ's sake. You understand? Woo! Anyway, man, I like it. I like the fact that he's going to take a general, but if you want my personal opinion, I believe, and look, I think that he needs to get a black vice president, either my man Herman Sugarcane or Ben Carson. I hate to say it. I mean, you know, look at how the left is pandering to these rabble-rouse Black Lives Matter contingent. I know for a fact that that's not all the black community. All right, I know that all the black community is not down with this ridiculous, pure thuggery that's being led around by a piggish power bottom in D-Ray. I know that that's not the case. All right? But, folks, I mean, these Black Lives Matter folks are being manipulated by a Democratic Party that is utilizing their ignorance against them. I mean, they're utilizing their ignorance against them. I mean, hey, Black Lives Matter, think about this for a second. There's a black president in office right now. There's a black Department of Justice in the freaking Obama administration. I mean, where are you and their goddamn, where's your criticism for them, for Christ's sake? I mean, who are you blaming for your strife when you've got a black president and you've got a black Department of Justice? Can somebody explain that to me? Explain it to me! Call me right now, Black Lives Matter, 516-453-9903. Call me right now. I want to hear from you. You justify this to me, for Christ's sake. You justify it, for Christ's sake. I want to hear from you. You're going to sit over here and try to justify this crap? You're being manipulated. And let me tell you, the reason why you're not as educated as you probably should be, Black Lives Matter, is because the government system for which public schools are funded are based upon property taxes. And 9 times out of 10, now black communities aren't necessarily always impoverished, but they're not necessarily 9 times out of 10 the richest parts of town in the town. And as a result, the public schools suffer because they don't raise the amount of property taxes, and as a result, you get substandard education. And that's why they can utilize your lack of intelligence against you, and that's what they're doing. They're utilizing the media. They're utilizing the speeches of Obama, the speeches of the Department of Justice. They're utilizing the funding of George Soros. I mean, don't you understand? I mean, do you understand this? I'm asking you a question, Black Lives Matter. Do you understand this? You have a black president. I mean, where's the criticism for this son of a bitch? How come he didn't take those billions, those hundreds of billions, almost $900 billion that was signed as soon as he came to office, $900 billion in stimulus package two? Why didn't he give any of that to the black community, huh? You know what he gave the black community, folks? He gave y'all the scraps. He gave y'all the beans, all right? He gave y'all the pennies. Whatever him and his cronies and the Democratic Party were, while they were dragging the bags out of the bank, while they were robbing the taxpayer bank, whatever was being dropped on the floor, that's what you folks got. I mean, Black Lives Matter, don't you understand that immigrants that aren't even citizens of this country are getting better entitlements from this government than you are? So what exactly are you upset about when in actuality all your strife, all of your problems, everything that is in your head that you believe is against you has happened within the past 8 years under a black president? I don't understand why anyone doesn't confront Black Lives Matter with this anomaly. I mean, you've got a black president. I mean, shouldn't you be pissed at him for not, you know, hooking the brothers up? He didn't even hook the brothers up, man. I'm serious. He's giving more of our tax money, Black Lives Matter, to immigrants, to wild Yehudis that are coming into this country that are going to be a lot more crazier and tougher than you are, folks. I mean, look, I know Black Lives Matter, you know, they listen to Tupac and they think that's a thug life and all this other crap. You don't know these battle-hardened Yehudis that cut heads and that kill children and rape women. You don't understand the type of brutality, the type of barbarism that is in these people's heads that Obama is transplanting from the Middle East into this country. I'm telling you, you Black Lives Matter, y'all been taken. Y'all been had. Y'all been hoodwinked, man. I mean, look at your leader, for Christ's sake. I mean, do you think that it's a coinkadink that D-Ray is a fruity-ass power bottom and you've got Barack Obama with, you know, the tranny, Michelle Obama, for Christ's sake? And look, if you don't believe she's a tranny, then you're an idiot, for Christ's sake, man. I mean, I've seen a lot of black women, and believe me, black women are stacked. They're big. They can be taller. But give me a break, man. Have you seen these disgusting man arms on this woman? I mean, do you understand that she doesn't have an hourglass figure like most women do? She's got disgusting man hands, for Christ's sake. I mean, we know who the bottom is in that relationship, and I don't think it's a coinkadink that you've got D-Ray, another power bottom, leading black folk around by the nose. And you know what, black folks, you need to come to grips with the realism that you have been had by people that are claiming to be your own race. And that's why when the Sean King thing came out and the Rachel Dolezal came out, and I heard black folk justifying this, I mean, with all due respect, I mean, that is the epitome of ignorance and brainwashing. I mean, the damn Democrats and the leftists have got you when you were justifying white people in blackface. I mean, do you understand? I mean, just imagine these racist liberals laughing their freaking asses off because you Black Lives Matter folk are justifying white people in blackface. And you see, if you justify white people in blackface, well, then you're going to justify what Obama's doing. And Obama's supposed to be a black president, but yet I have yet to see the black people rise in any capacity. In my view, folks, in the facts stated in the statistics of every black statistic in America, if you take a look at the statistics for the past 8 years, more blacks are on welfare. More blacks are addicted to drugs. More blacks are born out of wedlock. More black abortions. More black food cards. More black dropout rates. I mean, give me a break, man. And this is happening during a black president's tenure. And look, I know that you may be ignorant enough to believe that, well, that ain't true, baby. Obama's still doing what Bush had to deal with, baby. Obama's still dealing with what Bush had to do, baby. What is have Bush having to do with anything? This man has been in charge for 8 years, and the first thing he did when he came into office was pass the Stimulus Package 2 bill, which gave $900 billion to Wall Street, the banks, anyone who donated to the campaign contribution account of the Democrats or Obama, any of these scientists that are in the intelligentsia circuit that are down with the leftist idealism, the pornographic industry, the Hollywood, you know, freaking everybody got paid during Stimulus Package 2. Huh? I mean, seriously, everybody got paid during Stimulus Package 2 except you black folk. And like I said, all you black folk got was the beans, all right? Literal beans, for Christ's sake. And you notice that the beans that you're getting, I mean, now they haven't really raised it too much unless you shit it out another kid or done, you know, one of the other mechanisms for which you can get more money. You notice that that food card ain't going up and prices are rising. You know, you understand what I'm saying? Now, why are prices rising if food should be free to folks? Can you Black Lives Matter people answer that question? I'll tell you why, all right? Obama and the liberal regime have set it up in this capacity. You have to understand, the only way food prices go up and down is if people are actually paying for their goddamn food. But when you got more than half of America collecting food cards or some kind of a food entitlement to some degree, then there is going to be no prices that are fluctuating in capacity. As a matter of fact, it's going to go up in value just like colleges are going up in value. Don't you stupid idiots understand that? Anytime the government gets involved in anything, it ruins it. All you stupid college kids, you're putting yourselves in $60,000 in debt for a goddamn meaningless college degree that is, I mean, there's so many goddamn college degrees saturated in the market today that you're not even going to get yourself a goddamn job at Starbucks because there's so many goddamn degrees out here. And moreover, another thing that happened in Stimulus Package 2, jagoffs, was that Barack Obama federalized the student loan program, prohibiting college students from filing their college debt in bankruptcy like every one of your professors have done. And I repeat this over and over again. If you're going to college by some chance this semester coming up in the fall, ask your professors if they filed their damn college debt in bankruptcy, and let's see how honest they are, because I guarantee you at least 70% of the professors that are in the intelligentsia today basically put themselves in college debt to get a doctorate's degree, and then once they got their tenured position, all they had to do was say, I don't want to pay for my college debt. I'm going to throw it in bankruptcy. I'm going to file for bankruptcy and just throw all my debts in there. Who cares? I'm a high tenured earner in the collegiate field. Who cares? And, you know, 8 years later anyway, I can rebuild my credit, and I'm the man. And that's what happened, folks. That's what happened. And that's why I'm saying, folks, that's why now you can't do that. You can't file your student loan in a bankruptcy thanks to Mr. Yes We Can Obama over here. I know you dumbass college kids don't either want to realize that. You don't want to think about that, but that's the fucking truth. Excuse my French, all right? That's the damn truth. All right? Obama is the president that has prohibited each and every one of you students that are in college debt today from prohibiting you from relinquishing that debt via other mechanisms like bankruptcy. Moreover, folks, this is the only time in American history once President Obama took office. This is the first time in American history that students are going to have to pay for their damn student loans for life. I'm serious. I'm not joking. They're going to have to pay for their student loans for life. And you know who you're paying? You're paying the government. So it's not like you can just not pay that payment. I mean, they'll just take it out of your check just like they do Social Security, just like they do taxes. I mean, do you understand? This is what is going on. And you see, you Black Lives Matter folk, you college kids, you are being taken advantage of because you're ignorant. You're stupid. I mean, the first thing that you people need to come to grips with is that you're ignorant and you don't know shit from Shinola. And the sooner that you realize that, the better off you'll be. The better off you'll be. Then you'll start realizing that, hey, I better not believe anything that anybody on the boob tube tells me. I got to figure it out for myself. So anyway, folks, let's go back to the phone lines, folks. All right, let's open up some more lines here. How about area code 501? You're on the horn.
Hey, Goose, it's Rotten Snake. How are you doing?
How you doing, Rotten Snake? What's going on with you this Sunday? Or it should be Monday over there, I guess, right?
No, not yet. Not for another 15 minutes. But I'm just relaxing.
Okay.
I've just got a quick question for you. Obviously, I don't know if you've heard about what's going on over here on this side of the pond. I just want to know what your thoughts are on the Conservative election that's going on for the next Prime Minister.
Well, I am kind of aware of that. I am. I've been scoping out one of the candidates, Leadsom, I believe. And Leadsom sounds like a decent candidate. I haven't really, unfortunately, kept up too much with the British election situation because here in the just this whole week has been a bombardment of American news and a lot of American corruption being put forth and televised to the American folk. But why don't you enlighten us on some of the people that or the candidate that is in your political crosshairs?
Well, by the looks of things, the most favourite is Theresa May, by the looks of things, because between her and Leadsom, they're the main two that obviously won all the, the current election so far, like the counts, and they seem to be the top two, and I think Theresa May win it, to be honest.
Interesting. Is there a contrast on the policies of the two, or are they pretty much the same, maybe a couple of minor political differences?
Well, they're all about, obviously, dealing with the Brexit situation, obviously, like, negotiating, and what Theresa May recently said, apparently, they want to hold off till, obviously, enforcing Article 50 till, end of this year, at least.
Hey, let me tell you, I don't like that one bit, because I believe that they're going to try to do something to prevent Britain from leaving the EU. I think that they need to do this as quick as possible, as far as I'm concerned, but we shall see, you know what I mean?
Yeah, well, speaking of that, there was a recent response from the government regarding that that 4 million votes about, obviously, four million signatures about the referendum recount, and apparently they're saying it's not possible.
That's not possible, so it was a fraud?
No, it's not that. It's just apparently it was already decided back in December 2015 that there was no specific, overall majority. It's like if it's 50 or more. They didn't really specify any numbers, and it's apparently, being as Westminster Hall obviously can't change the law, they've obviously deferred it obviously somewhere else. I can't remember exactly where.
Interesting. Hey, stay there, Raiden Snake. We're going to come back to you here. We're celebrating, once again, Black Lives Matter, coming out of the closet. They are now an LGBT organization. And we got Raiden Snake, of course, enlightening us a lot about the Britannia politics. And look, we should really focus a little bit when we have time on the Britannia politics, because they were the ones that set all this off. The whole reason why we're seeing all this incremental or fast incrementalism of totalitarianism is because Britannia stood up against the international bureaucrats. All right? I mean, I'm serious, for Christ's sake. International bureaucrats. Woo! Anyway, let's continue going, all right? Let's take a couple more callers here on this free format random Sunday edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. We got area code 727. You're on the horn. What's up?
Hey, Ghost. How are you doing, man?
Hey, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good. I'm with my mom right now. I don't know if you remember our talk yesterday, right?
No, I remember. I remember Grandpa AIDS and all that stuff. What do you got to say?
I just got to say, and I don't want to get in too much into that right now, but I'm pretty sure D-Ray should just go to prison instead, because, you know, he'll get a lot of meat there, you know?
Well, you know, that's the point. I mean, that's the thing. Maybe he's not afraid to go to jail because he wants to go to jail. You know what I mean? Maybe he wants to go to jail. I mean, it's a freaking meat market for him in there, for Christ's sake, man. I'm not joking. It's a freaking meat market for him over there. That guy would just, he would go into prison backwards. All right? I'm serious. I mean, his asshole would be puckered up as soon as he went into the maximum security prison. All right? And that's another thing. How do you like that there, Black Lives Matter? Huh? That, you know, typically when one goes to jail for political purposes, they don't want to go to jail. You know, there's not going to be any gratification for jail, because jail means that you cannot live your life. But you see, when you're a piggish power bottom fruit bowl like D-Ray over here, that's a dream come true. Prison bitching is a dream come true for D-Ray, for Christ's sake.
The deals are getting hotter during the Deer Days of Summer. Get 0% financing for 60 months on all John Deere compact tractors. Plus, get a best-in-class 6-year powertrain warranty at no additional cost. Hurry in today for the hot deals of summer. Offer ends August 2nd, 2016, subject to approved installment credit with John Deere Financial. Terms, conditions, exclusions, and warranty limitations apply. See dealer for details.
Visit your local John Deere dealer today to take advantage of special savings going on now. Find out more at myjohndeeredealer.com.
And let me tell you, I mean, how does that make y'all feel in Black Lives Matter? I'm still waiting for a Black Lives Matter supporter. I doubt they're going to call up, because, I mean, Black Lives Matter fears the Capitalist Army, folks. It's no joke. I mean, if y'all witnessed last night on the Twitter account, Politics Ghost, that should prove to all of you that Black Lives Matter fears the Capitalist Army. Anyway, let's take some more callers here. 818, you're on the horn. What's up?
Hey, Ghost. They were broadcasting you at AnthroCon in Pittsburgh.
They were what?
They were broadcasting you at a furry convention in Pittsburgh, and there was like 1,000 people gathered around.
I don't want to know. I don't want to know. God, man. I'm being broadcasted at BronyCon. I'm being broadcasted at FurryCon. I don't want to know. All right, I don't want to know. I mean, we're talking about Fruit Bowl D-Ray here. We're talking about how Black Lives Matter has come out of the closet, and it is an LGBT organization. They have come out of the closet. Anyway, Jesus Christ, I'm being broadcast in a furry convention. I mean, come on! Oh, Jesus Christ. How about area code 901? You're on the horn.
Hey, guys, what's up? How you doing, man?
How you doing?
Pretty good, man. Hey, I just wanted to, like, put a comparison out between black rights and women's rights, because, you know, we gave women rights, and now you got this feminist shit going on. They don't have enough rights. They need everything. They pretty much just want to get put in a man's place. And then you get black people, you start giving them rights, and they're not going to be happy until they have all the same shit or completely replace the white people.
Hold on a second. I mean, what rights? They've got rights. What are you talking about? If we give them rights, they've got rights. I mean, they have the right to go out and educate themselves. They've got the right to go out and be entrepreneurs. They got the right to go out and work. They've got the right to go out and vote. They've got the right to go out and be productive members of society. They just choose to go another direction. And whether that's voluntary, whether that's media-induced, whether that's government-induced, whether that's society-induced is a whole other debate. But they've got rights, man. I mean, this is not like women's strife. When women didn't have the right to vote, then women weren't a citizen. But I do agree with you that now that women are, you know, supposedly liberated, now they want to be communist about it and take over the whole goddamn country. You know, and I find it ironic that these same feminists will defend Islam, even though Islam wants to oppress them and put them in burqas and beekeeper suits. And, you know, maybe there's something to that. Maybe deep down inside, these feminists, they want a wild Yehudi to slap them around, you know, throw them in a beekeeper suit, you know, have about three or four wives, for Christ's sake. I mean, I'm honestly starting to believe that. I mean, there is no justification for a feminist to justify Islam when the majority of Islam oppresses women, treats women as below second-class citizens, like subhuman, for Christ's sake. And yet you've got feminists that defend this crap. I'm telling you, deep down inside, I believe feminists want to get pimp slapped around, and they want to be abused and want a freaking beekeeper suit thrown on them. I'm just saying, I mean, I don't see another justification other than that. I don't see any other justification for why these feminists are backing up wild Yehudis. I just don't get it. Anyway, I think we got the Teutonic Plague in the house. What's going on, Teutonic?
Hey, Ghost, how you doing? I'm reveling here. I'm loving this shit, man. I mean, I know D-Ray's out of jail, but we take our victories where we can, man.
I know, and as you can see, D-Ray being released party is a hashtag trending right here. I think that everybody, as a matter of fact, go ahead and say what you're going to say. I'm gonna do something here in a second.
All right, well, first, I want to do a sip. You want to do a sip of some Black Lives Matter tears after the doxings and the capitalist army doing some digital damage? I retweeted those doxes, giving you credit, of course, for the folks that are following me but aren't following you. You want to do a sip of some Black Lives Matter tears?
Sure. I've got some scotch right here, man. Got the cheers, and we're sipping on Black Lives Matter tears because not only do they get outed and spotlighted, but they are now out of the closet in an LGBT organization. Cheers, man. Black Lives Matter tears taste so goddamn good. A little tangy. You know, I can definitely taste the ramen noodle in that, but I'm just joking. I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
I know. It's okay. You are not a racist, Ghost. You're a melting pot of friendship. So it's okay.
I really am. I'm glad that you're highlighting that, Plague. I'm a freaking melting pot of friendship, and I'm tired of being labeled anything otherwise.
That's like, I know this sounds like a cop-out, sir, but you are literally so not racist that you can get away with spouting racial humor and people still will say that you're not racist because you're that good, man.
Hey, man, I appreciate that. Hey, stay right there, Plague, because what I want to do is I want to do some Twitter shout-outs here, but before I do, I'm gonna tweet another tweet here, all right? I'm going to tweet another tweet. Let me do something here really fast, folks, so that we can get to some Twitter shout-outs, because I am just completely disgusted that D-Ray's release party, whatever the hell the hashtag is trending out here. And, I mean, we got to make sure that everybody knows that, D-Ray is taken in the pooper. I mean, and if that's the case, then Black Lives Matter needs to come to grips with the fact that, that they're a damn LGBT movement. I mean, and that's all there is to it. They are an LGBT movement, and they need to understand that they're being led around by a goddamn piggish power bottom. And I want to know if actually D-Ray has a goddamn Grindr account, because I'm almost certain anybody who's a goddamn piggish power bottom fruit bowl has got one of those sons of bitches. I'm almost certain. I'm willing to put money on it, for Christ's sake. All right? All right, let me go ahead and type something here real fast. I'm going to put Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, and then I'm going to put, the D-Ray release party, because, folks, I mean, they need to realize what exactly is going on, all right? They need to realize that, and they need to debate that amongst themselves on whether or not they're going to continue to cause violence and continue to rabble-rouse, and they're going to continue to go out here and destroy property in the name of some glory hole serving fruit bowl. I mean, let's be honest. And if that's the case, well, then let's stop talking about, thuggery and thug life and Tupac or whatever, gangsterism or whatever the case might be. You understand that? Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and tweet this right here. It's a very simple tweet. As a matter of fact, let me go ahead and put a picture on this, folks. I'm sorry, I'm doing this in mid-broadcast, for Christ's sake, because it needs to be done. These goddamn Black Lives Matter supporters should know that they are being led around by an LGBT community, for Christ's sake, all right? Jesus Christ. Anyway, let me go ahead and put one more hashtag. I'm going to put the hashtag Black Twitter because, there's a lot of supporters of Black Lives Matter there. Here we go, folks. There it is. We have now tweeted the tweet. Please retweet the tweet. Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization. Hashtag D-Ray has been released party. Hashtag Black Twitter. All right? You retweet that right there. I will give you a Twitter shout-out right here live on the broadcast, baby. You understand what I'm saying? Woo! All right, let's get to it. Sergeant Yoda right off the bat. We got the green bio in the house. Undertale for Pope. What the hell is that supposed to mean? We got Big Tough Capitalist in the house. Somebody's gay for D-Ray. That's real funny. Somebody's gay for D-Ray. Now, that's just great. We got Commander Biff in the house. We got Crusades for Arabs. It may come down to that. I don't know. It may just come down to that, for Christ's sake. Anyway, let's continue going, shall we? Tweet the first tweet on my Twitter account, the one that says Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, baby. Anyway, on that note, we got somebody by the name of Colin Tenderizer. Jesus Christ. Cody from Unknown in the place. We've got Caroline's Fruitcake. Yeah, real funny ass crack. We got Redemption 47. Cheeky Beaky, for Christ's sake. We got Exara Hawks in the house. We got Ass Banquet. Jesus Christ. We got three-way for D-Ray. Oh, my God. Good God. I don't even want to know. That picture is a horrific picture. Jesus Christ. D-Ray McGosler. You son of a bitch. Shut up your ass, for Christ's sake. Anyway, we got Angry Manju in the house, for Christ's sake. We got somebody by the name of You Should Go on YouTube. Are you serious? I mean, is that a real name? YouTube! It's YouTube! Oh, my God. We got Metal Capitalist in the house. We've got the Foot Job Kid. Used and Abused Engineer. Shove it up your ass, for Christ's sake, man. Shove it up your ass! Coal for Ghost. Oh, yeah, Coal for Ghost, because I don't like Christmas, all right? Who cares? All right? Who cares? Man, I haven't had a Christmas present in years, baby. I mean, I can't even think back how long I haven't had a damn Christmas present, boy. But I don't give a crap. Anyway, we got Exara Hawks in the house. We got Senpai, J-Rob. We got Blake in the place. We got Mr. Zen in the house. What's going on to Mr. Zen? We've got, I'm not going to say that disgusting name, you fruit bastard. Who the hell else? We got Full Metal Fetish. We've got the Jizzmaster 3000. We've got D-Raped in prison. Oh, man. I mean, I don't think that's a bad thing for this man. I think he actually wants it. I mean, that's the bad part about it. I don't think a prison sentence is going to phase this D-Ray. I mean, he wants meat in his can. He wants to take old One Eye up his holiest of holies. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Jesus Christ. Anyway, we got D-Ray Deflowered. I'm sure he was a deflowered a long time ago, for Christ's sake. Are you kidding me? Jesus Christ. We got Group Poop Dynamics. We've got Torzier in the place. What's going on? We've got, I'm not saying, you see, you assholes are starting to get sick with this crap. We got the 3DS Capitalist, for Christ's sake. 3DS Capitalist. Jesus Christ, people are still playing the 3DS? Anyway, who else do we got going on over here? One Mogan, and then that's it here. We got Havel the Rock. We've got, I'm not saying that name. We got No Gifts for Ghost, LOL. Shove it up your ass, asshole! We've got Godzilla in the place, Blasphemous Bastard. We've got the Happy Merchant, Bloodfart. There's Bloodfart. We got D-Ray Ping. D-Ray Ping. I'm telling you, trolls, man. The Brony Network in the house. We've got, I'm not going to say that disgusting name, for Christ's sake. Oh, there's the Whore Master. Oh, yes, I am the Whore Master. Oh, yes, I'm the Whore Master. We got Trans VP, for Christ's sake. Oh, that's, no. We got No Leeway for D-Ray. We've got Gray. We've got Ghost Trey, whatever the hell that's supposed to mean. Now shut up your ass. Don't compare me to D-Ray. Jesus Christ, man. Anyway, let's continue going, because I want to make sure that everybody on that damn trend that D-Ray has been released party understands that Black Lives Matter is a goddamn LGBT organization, and that's why I am asking everybody to retweet the damn broadcast. All right, baby? Everybody retweet this first tweet on my Twitter account, Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, right now, baby. All right, let me do one more, and then that's it. We're going to go on to Radio Graffiti for all the folks that are listening in. Who else do we got going on over here for Twitter shout-outs? We got President Brian in the house. What's going on, President Brian? We got That's Mimi in the place. We've got, I'm not going to say that disgusting name, Hans Gubensmits in the house, BLM Tears, LOL, hey, I hear what you're saying. We got Artron Havoc, Colon Buffet, oh, Jesus Christ, D-Ray Power Top Ghost, you son of a bitch, you sick son of a bitch. Me up with D-Ray, for Christ's sake. That's it. No more Twitter shout-outs, for Christ. No more. All right? This is why we can't have nice things. This is why. I'm sitting here. I'm trying to be a little interactive with the show, but this is the kind of garbage I get. All right? This is the kind of garbage I get, for Christ's sake. Give me the mic. Give me the mic. The goddamn mic. I'm telling you this right now, all right? That's why I'm asking everybody to retweet that first tweet, all right? Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, and anybody who doesn't understand that, anybody that doesn't want to put that through their fat, stinking, stupid, thick-ass head is completely insane. They're completely moronic. They're stupid. Anyway, we got somebody by the name of Summer of Digital Chaos. I had to definitely shout that one out, for Christ's sake, because that's what we're conducting here, all right? I mean, look at all the digital damage that we did last night, for Christ's sake, all right? We gave out the information to D-Ray, Nita, and we're going to continue to release and spotlight these domestic terrorists and Black Lives Matter so that the public can know who exactly is behind this and ask them a few questions and give them a communication avenue so they can ask them a few questions on why. Why are they doing this?
Fios is not cable. We're wired differently, which means you can get the fastest internet available with equal upload and download speeds from 50 to 500 megs. So you can upload 200 photos before your favorite song is finished. Click the ad and switch to Fios today to get our best offer ever.
Jesus Christ. Anyway, folks, I want to thank everybody for retweeting that tweet, because let me tell you something right now. This is how we get through the minds of these simplistic imbeciles that are being mesmerized by this Black Lives Matter crap, because it's being overly pumped on the lamestream mainstream media. All right? I'm not joking. This is how we combat these pieces of trash. Anyway, folks, before I get into Radio Graffiti, I definitely want to extend one more call to action to all the trolls and hackers on the internets. It is time to do some digital damage to Black Lives Matter. If they're going to go out and they're going to rabble-rouse and they're going to agitate violence all across the country, then we are within our moral, ethical, and legal right to basically retaliate on a digital front. And as you saw, what yours truly and the Capitalist Army did last night is just a small tip of the goddamn iceberg, man. A very small tip of the iceberg. You understand? And let me tell you, we have to start doing this. We have to start making sure that these Black Lives Matter imbeciles understand that there is a repercussion to their rabble-rousing of violence. And let me tell you, that's why none of these Black Lives Matter folks wants to come at the Capitalist Army. I mean, they already know, hey, if we could get to D-Ray and we could get to, Nita and all these other, Tefpo and all these other idiots, I mean, what is it for us not to get to them? You understand? What's that for us not to get to them, for Christ's sake? I mean, good God! That's why I'm calling on all the trolls, I'm calling on all the hackers throughout the internet. It's time for a summer of digital chaos, baby! I'm calling on the Capitalist Army! I'm calling on trolls! I'm calling on hackers! It's time! It's time! It's time! It's time for a summer of digital chaos since you've got Black Lives Matter trying to implement violence on a national scale so that this leftist administration, this communist administration, can implement martial law. And we can't do it. We can't allow them to do it. We can't let them do it. That's why we got to do whatever we do. We got to do whatever we can do out here. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, folks. And let me tell you something right now. If you don't believe that Black Lives Matter fears the Capitalist Army, tweet at Nita, tweet at D-Ray, and tell them that you're a part of the Capitalist Army and see how fast they ignore you. Why are they ignoring you? Why are they ignoring the Capitalist Army? Why are they ignoring yours truly? Because they know we know. You understand that? They know, we know, and they're scared shitless, all right? And all they can do to retaliate is rabble-rouse a bunch of uneducated individuals into violence. That's the basis of their whole existence. That's the basis of their whole spotlight. That's the basis of their whole fame whore attention, is that D-Ray and Nita, these two individuals, are utilizing their slight bit of intelligence, because they're not very intelligent, but they're more intelligent than the majority of Black Lives Matter supporters, and they are utilizing their ignorance to rabble-rouse and to cause chaos and to cause havoc and to cause violence. Because if D-Ray and Nita were true leaders, they'd be out here trying to educate their own people. They'd be out there trying to tell their people, hey, look, this is how you get an economic opportunity, all right? This is how you do these types of things to progress your community, build your businesses, get a job. This is how you confront law enforcement with actual legal ease instead of confronting them with ghettofied degeneracy, for Christ's sake. Give me a freaking break. Oh, my God. And I'm already getting some repercussions from, I guess, the tweet that you folks retweeted here. Let me see if it is. Yes, it is. It says, You are filthy effing diseases. You're the reason the world needs a new plague. And then calls me a faggot. I mean, doesn't that defeat the purpose on what I'm saying? Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization. I put D-Ray in drag. And this, at A.M., a man is no one. A man is N-O and the number one. That's who tweeted at me. That doesn't even make any sense. You see how ignorant these people are? She's bitching at me because I am saying that Black Lives Matter is an LGBT organization, and yet she comes back at me with the word faggot. I mean, that makes no sense whatsoever. But you see, this is the type of mental capacity we're dealing with as it relates to this Black Lives Matter organization. I mean, they are ignorant, man. They're stupid. Oh, my God. Anyway, folks, without any further ado, let's just go ahead and get on to Radio Graffiti on this random Sunday edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast, where we're celebrating Black Lives Matter coming out of the closet. They are now an LGBT organization. Good God. Woo! Anyway, folks, hey, do we have any Radio Graffiti calls, engineer? All right, well, we got a few Radio Graffiti calls, and we're going to take them right now. And for you folks that are unfamiliar with Radio Graffiti, all you have to do is give me a call right now at 516-453-9903. That's 516-453-9903. When I call on your area code, you have exactly 3 to 4 seconds to say whatever it is that's on your mind. And that's what is Radio Graffiti. It's where the spectators become a part of the spectacles. And we're going to get to them right now, baby. How about area code 956, Radio Graffiti?
It's a pony kind of
No, no, no pony crap. No pony crap, please. Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Tango Whiskey, what's up?
So let's go ahead and let's play this. This is for Black Lives Matter coming out of the closet, baby. Go ahead and put it on, engineer.
Black man in a white man's town. He's got trouble. Get in his way, he's gonna cut you down. Take it all.
You know what? I'm not letting that finish for crying. I'm not letting it finish. I'm not letting it finish. Shut up. 480 Radio Graffiti. Oh, Jesus Christ, a Helen Keller deaf mute. Get it straight. 609 Radio Graffiti. What are you idiots doing, man? Why are you clogging up the lines if you're not going to say a goddamn thing, you Helen Keller deaf mute scumbags? Jesus Christ. 904 Radio Graffiti.
Hey, Ghost. This is Ekazoi. I'm actually pretty happy to hear that old D right here is a flushbacker because he's like an embarrassment to the black community. And I right now feel like celebrating. It feels like Christmas in July right now. Yeah, come on.
No, don't look. I was with you until you started saying it's Christmas. I don't want to hear nothing about Christmas, all right? We're not even done with summer, and you jerk dicks are sitting there waxing your carrot about goddamn Christmas. Give me a goddamn break. 415, Radio Graffiti.
This is True Paranoid Radio. True Paranoid Radio.
I am your host, the man they call Ghost.
The scaredy of scaredy cats.
He puts the para in paranoia.
I'm in a freaking wheelchair. Ghost there.
Broadcasting live from his room in a beautiful Starwood Hotel.
You know, I saw ice cream trucks outside of my damn house in the middle of winter. And
now he'll take it from here. The fat ass of phobia. The man they call
Ghost.
Shove it up your ass, asshole. Look, I don't know how many times I got to tell you stupid scumbags, leave my intro alone, asshole, all right? That's the greatest intro in radio today. Son of a bitch. Anyway, we got 832 Radio Graffiti.
Hello, Ghost. This is Gilmit for Geekberg, and I was wondering if you want to have a threesome with me and D-Ray. I think it'll be
fun. Jesus Christ. No, Kermit, no! But I'm sure D-Ray is on all fours, and, you know, I'm sure he wouldn't mind if you have a spare rodent. You know, never mind. Anyway, who else do we got? We got Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Hello, Ghost. This is Kermit the Gay Frog, and I was wondering if my tongue would be very good in
Wait, what the hell? Shut up, Kermit! How many numbers do you have, Kermit? God damn it! Jesus Christ, I'm being freaking butt-stalked by a fucking frog, for Christ's sake. Excuse my French, I'm sorry. Sorry, excuse my French, didn't mean to curse there, but Jesus Christ, you hear this crap? Anyway, area code 309, Radio Graffiti. Oh, Jesus Christ, you idiot. How about anonymous Radio Graffiti? I need to take some more cocaine.
Achoo!
Woo! Now, shut up! No. Don't even go there, all right? Don't even go there, ass crack. Anyway, who else do we got? 712 Radio Graffiti.
Hey, what's up, Ghost?
How you doing?
Not too bad. Hey, I'm at Treasure Island if you want to meet up for some drinks later in Austin.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Not you, for Christ's sake. Look, stop asking me out on a date, all right? I don't want to meet you, all right? Jesus Christ, man. Take about 10 steps away from my freaking butt crack with that talk. Good God. How about 585, Radio Graffiti?
Hey, Ghost, I got my Johnny Walker Red Label here waiting for silver to go up over $20.50 an ounce. So, yeah, it's all good.
Hey, thank you very much for entertaining that particular investment advice. And don't be sweating the retraction that we're having, a slight bit of retraction in oil and a couple other commodities, because, folks, the only reason that the stock market is going up is because of the fictitious numbers that are coming out as it relates to the employment numbers. And moreover, this Hillary Clinton acquittal or non-prosecution is definitely something that spurred the markets a little bit. I mean, as sick as that sounds, remember, folks, Wall Street has merged with government. And you see, Donald Trump is going to be bad for Wall Street. Unlike Hillary Rotten Clinton, who is Mrs. Wall Street, all you have to do is just take a look at her campaign contribution account and take a look at how much money she has from Wall Street. That'll say everything. Anyway, let's continue going, shall we? We got anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Hey, Teutonic Flag.
What?
Cracker.
What the hell was that? What kind of a goddamn splice was that? That was ridiculous. 469, Radio Graffiti.
Too many people have lost sight of the true meaning of Christmas.
Oh, hush.
Shut up, Ralphie. So now, in the spirit of the original,
thank you.
Tradition. American Christmas.
Like what?
MGM presents A Christmas Story.
No, I don't want to hear anything about goddamn Christmas right now. Do you understand that, people? I don't know why you keep trolling me with this crap. And not to mention, the Christmas Story is the epitome of why the baby boomers think they're so goddamn entitled, for Christ's sake. You know, a perfect clip from that movie is when Ralphie and his friend encourage their, quote, friend to stick his tongue on that damn frozen pole, and his tongue gets stuck, and then the bell rings, and they just leave their friend there, and they ask, hey, Ralphie, what are you going to do? He's stuck in a pole. He's your friend. But the bell rang. The bell rang. I mean, that is a quintessential bureaucratic baby boomer response to every single goddamn thing they've ever conducted in this life. So anyway, let's continue going. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
It's alive.
Here we go again. They're trying to make me out to be Dr. Frankenstein. I don't even know why that damn troll came about, but good God, you trolls, you got a lot of freaking problems, man. Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
But the police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad because I'm brown. And not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority.
And, you know, that's who Black Lives Matter should be pissed at. Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, Snoop Dogg. I mean, when these people put out this gangster rap garbage back in the beginning of the 90s, that was the beginning of the glorification of ghetto-fied degeneracy. And now, ghetto-fied degeneracy, or a.k.a. rapper hip-hop, is now synonymous with black culture. I'm telling you, Malcolm X would be sick if he saw this crap. He'd be disgusted. But, you know, you idiots, you think that, I don't know what y'all are proud about, but it's pretty pathetic, all right? Seriously. Anyway, who else do we got here? We got area code 818, Radio Graffiti.
I see you're selling out again, Ghost, promoting YouTube channels on your fucking broadcast. Wow.
Promoting YouTube channel? What YouTube channel did I promote?
Keemstar. Keemstar.
I didn't, but shut up, you stupid idiot. Good God. And isn't Keemstar like, isn't he like suing a 15-year-old who trolled him or something? What a piece of trash. 901, Radio Graffiti.
Hey, Ghost. Fucking, what do you think about how every time a white person kills a black person, it's a hate crime, but you get 12 black people like jump a white guy or something, and the motive is unknown? Or the shooter in Dallas, he wanted to kill white cops, but the motive is unknown. What do you think about that?
Well, you know, you got a very valid point there. That's why I was never in agreement with these so-called hate crime bills, because all it does is it protects a certain group of people and neglects another group of people. I mean, a crime is a crime. You know, I mean, if you commit murder on somebody, you commit murder. All right, and it's up to a jury or a prosecutor to figure out what degree of murder that you are attempting to be convicted of. I mean, I never understood this. A crime is a damn crime, but you see, this is what these leftists did. They like to, you know, create these laws so that they can make supra groups of people and more important groups of people, so on and so forth. And hey, asshole, I know Snoop Dogg wasn't an NWA ass crack. I'm just saying that. That whole movement from NWA to the Chronic album to the Doggy Style album is really the catalyst of the degeneracy of black folk. And that's all I got to say about it. I mean, just imagine how many black folk have been shot, killed, raped, whatever, to this music. And we're encouraged by this music. So just chew on that for a little bit. All right, how about 309, Radio Graffiti?
Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's up?
No.
Hey, how you doing? Anyway, how about Anonymous Radio Graffiti?
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
Shut up with the freaking Christmas carols, damn it! Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Happy Hanukkah.
Happy Hanukkah. I'm not Jewish, asshole, all right? I am not a Jew. I use yarmulkes for coffee filters, all right? Give me a damn break. 864 Radio Graffiti.
Hey, Ghost, this is Kermit the Sexless Frog here. Just wanting to say, stop capitalism and have a merry fucking...
Oh, shut up. And look, now we got the impersonators of Kermit the Frog. I mean, come on with these trolls. Jesus Christ, they're pathetic. Anonymous, Radio Graffiti.
I'm calling on you to conduct yourself in the summer of digital chaos. I got your terrorist organization right here. The Capitalist Army is a domestic terrorist organization.
Shut up. Don't even kid around about that. Don't even kid around about that splice. Seriously, you scumbags. I'm not joking around. Stupid sons of bitches. You keep that up and see. You know, if you keep that up, let's see if I continue to still broadcast, you sacks of shit. Son of a bitch. Anyway, who else do we got? We got Eric, another anonymous, Radio Graffiti.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, Ghost, I was wondering if I could buy, like, if you're going to sell those cans, can I buy, like, 20 of them? Because I was thinking about, like, molding into a dick ring for me and tough guy, because we're going to be my boys together. Is that cool with you?
unfortunately, I could not even understand what the hell you're saying because it sounds like you're trying to deep throat the microphone, for Christ's sake. It's not your dad's phallic. Jesus Christ. Another anonymous Radio Graffiti.
This is Black Lives Matter Radio. Black Lives Matter Radio.
I am your host, the man they call T-Ray.
The badass of terrorism. Give him terrorism or give him death.
That's it. Period.
Broadcasting from the street side protest in beautiful downtown Dallas, Texas.
It will be legal in Dallas, Texas to shoot cops.
Now, he'll take it from here. Your host, the protester of protesters, the man they call D-Ray.
Oh, man, you son of a... God! That's it! You son of a bitch! How dare you? How dare you, troll, sit there and try to commiserate me with that freaking pinkish power bottom D-Ray? How dare you? How goddamn dare you? Good God, I can't believe you people. I can't believe you people! Son of a bitch. Give me the mic. Give me the mic. Goddamn mic. I can't believe you people, you goddamn scumbags. I've told you sorry sacks of crap to leave my intro the hell alone, all right? That is the greatest intro in radio today. Jesus Christ. Anyway, folks, we're almost out of time for the live broadcast. And let me tell you something right now. I'm not going to have a third post-show edition hour because it's Sunday, for Christ's sake. This is supposedly God's rest day. So I thought it was important that I come up on here and let Black Lives Matter know that they're being pulled out of the closet. They are an LGBT organization. But don't fret, folks. I will be back tomorrow, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. I broadcast every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time at blogtalkradio.com/ghost is the official website of the True Capitalist Radio Show. It is blogtalkradio.com/ghost. And if you haven't already done so, folks, please follow me on Twitter. The Twitter name to follow is PoliticsGhost. All one word, no underscores, politics ghost. Anyway, folks, I would like to thank you for tuning in with me. I will be back tomorrow, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. It is the summer of digital chaos, baby. The summer of digital chaos. Don't you ever forget it. And follow me on Twitter, folks. Politics ghost is the name to follow. All right? I'm out of here. Long live the capitalist army, baby. I am out.
So you bought a car, and now you can't afford to buy anything else. Did you know? You don't have to be stuck paying a high interest rate on your auto loan. At Westcom, you may be able to refinance your car loan to a lower rate. Westcom is member-owned, so we have great rates, which means buying a set of wheels doesn't have to put you on the road to regret. Check out our great rates at westcom.org. Certain restrictions and conditions may apply. Loan approval subject to credit and income evaluation.
Summer is about family and fun, and when it's centered on a great meal, it's just better. Good thing your neighborhood Albertsons has great deals on all the favorites that make summer just better. This week, serve up boneless, skinless chicken breast or thighs, perfect for grilling, just $1.77 a pound when you buy 3 pounds or more. And pick up sweet savings on fresh local strawberries, 1 pound packages, 2 for $3. Tastier meats, sweeter savings, better summers. Albertsons, it's just better.